It's just after 7 a.m. in Canada's largest city, and volunteers are out before the commuters looking for birds, dead ones.
Is it really a million birds a year?
Is it?
Today's a good day. They haven't found any dead birds yet.
This is a rose-breasted grosbeak.
But back at base, there's a freezer full of migrating birds the volunteers say were killed when they mistakenly crashed into buildings.
The birds that we encounter play key roles in our ecosystem. They consume billions of insects, pollinate flowers, distribute seeds.
A unique court case is underway in Toronto to make building owners responsible for the bird deaths.
This is the office complex at the center of the pioneering lawsuit. Campaigners allege that the reflective glass makes the building so invisible to migrating birds that thousands have died here in the past 10 years.
Lawyers are asking a court to make it mandatory for all buildings to have a special visible film or marker on windows up to 16 meters high. They hope the case will set a precedent.
If the courts find that there is a contravention of the law here, they can not only impose very significant fines, up to $6 million per day, but can also order a company to take action to remediate the problem.
In the Toronto suburb of Markham, the local council has already spent over $40,000 on window film to protect birds at some of its key buildings.
We wanted to retrofit this building so that we could say we have taken a leadership role, we have retrofitted our building, and then we could show this as an example.
Back in the city centre, the hunt for dead birds goes on. The volunteers are hoping the court will soon make their early morning foray for the carcasses unnecessary. John Terrett, Al Jazeera, Toronto.